I have written a question, so we will sort out this today. Okay. Let's first okay. one is company name and then this one. Okay. Before that, I have to, you know, let you know, you know, yesterday we were struggling to, you know, comment a line, right? So I noticed it, a hash symbol, it will comment a single line and then backslash and then star. If you start there, you can enter as many lines you want, and then when you have to finish with that. Okay, so in between whatever it is, see, can you see that? That is a yes, line. Sir. So this will be commented. Okay, so after this, if you put two hyphen or underscore, I forgot somehow, you know, it is not working for me now. You can type anything. It's supposed not to raise error, but here it is raising an error. Okay, let's do that. Next one. Let's move on. One more thing I have to tell you before, you know, when you use foreign key, primary key constraints, primary key. So how do you call that? How do you display, select item name, and then, you know, how do you match it? You know, especially if you give the select, you know, column name and then comma, you know, different table column name. From you are using, you know, customer name or orders table, right? So table name, right? So suppose in customer table, let me take that one. He will understand. Where is customer table? Okay, here customer table, we have branch as SID and then last name, first name. So orders table, we have different attribute name, right? In case if I change this one customer ID to exactly how it looks like here, because the customer table is SID. If you you know, when you want to display, so you know, sometimes in the customer table we have plenty of them, but orders table only few of them, right? So, you know, not all the customer will purchase particular item, or they will go there, right? Do you understand what I mean, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
You know, customer, you can have many customer in customer table, but if you select order table, what will happen? You know, few customer only order that particular item, right? But you, when you writing a query, you want to display many customers. How many customers in your table? You want to display everything. Every customer. So that time, if you know, we have mentioned that in orders table and customer table, both table, customer ID or customer name, same, exactly same column name. So how do you, you know, declare here in your textbook? I don't see any options. You know, in basically is MySQL, Oracle, or any databases, you can do that using some special operation. How do you do that? So, let's see, select, let me, this one is system, right? Okay. Oh, okay, before that, I need to change it. Without changing it, I can write it. Select, if from customer table, we can pick some of the column. So SID, okay? SID, then comma, what you do? First name, comma, first name, first underscore name, comma, then if you go to orders ID, so, you know, we have only customer, the relation between, orders ID and customer ID, we have this column, right? The customer SID. So, but here column name is different between each table. So this, according to this table, this is fine. Sometimes, you know, I may fetch to customer name itself. So the I may specifically mention same column name. So what you will do, so you will write orders dot, you know, first name underscore name, then from which table, from customer comma orders. So So imagine in our customer table, we have first name as well. Same exact, you know, this way. In orders table also, we have same name. So if you want to pick any one name, I told you customer have, you know, in customer table can have many customer, you know, maybe 25 customers. But order table, not every customer will purchase something, right? So in order table, we will have only few of them. So in one point of time, you want to display whoever or place, you know, we register in a first name. So if you want to display, so, you know, that will, you know, create a problem because we have a record in customer table plenty, more than 25. But orders table, we will only 5 of them, imagine. So that time, if you just simply say that our first name, you know, it will give contradiction, right? So which first name you want to display, from customer table or order table? So yeah, always you do that, orders or customers, customers, customers dot first name, then pick from that table name. So instead of doing this, we can, you know, we can write other way. For example, in here in a customer order table, we are assigning that column name same exactly SID. So what you have to do, you can give any alias name A dot SID and then rest of the name. You know, because we have customer table, we have one first name, but orders table, we don't have first name. So you don't need to worry about it. But here you have to declare customer comma, sorry, customer one white space, blank space, and then order blank space B. Okay, then we will pick some of the column from order table, order ID and then order date. Okay, so let's try that. Order ID underscore ID comma order date. What is that? Underscore date from customer A or comma and customer B. So you want to display, you have to match that, right? SID equal to, you know, customer dot SID equal to you know, orders dot customer underscore that one, right? So you have to write it. Otherwise, you know, you will get a Cartesian product, right? So how do you write A dot, you know, S underscore ID equal to, you know, B dot customer, your customer underscore S underscore ID. So in this way, you can write that query. So you understand this, guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, you don't want to, you know, if you are going to pick many of them, you know, here if you want to display 5 rows or, you know, 5 columns or, you know, maybe more than that, each time you don't want to write a customer dot, maybe order table also same exact name as a customer table. So at that time, you know, you have to explicitly specify customer dot SID, customer dot first name, and then order dot order ID. In this way, you don't want to write it. So, you know, my SQL, Oracle, VBA, everything will let you write like that. So just give a alias name, A. So which means if you define here, you have to assign customer equal to A. So you are mentioning that, you know, customer table as a name as a A. So you can define here A dot something. So which means it will pick from customer table, pick this column. Okay. So if you don't give, you know, A dot or B dot, and nothing worry, nothing wrong. You know, it will check both tables. Okay. Where is that exact first name? So it will select from there. Okay. Okay, guys, do you want me to run that query? We have, you know, okay, let me run. We have. I have noted down. Yesterday I have run this and then marked it down. I don't know where it is. One second, guys. Okay, you know that meaning of a wildcard operator, right? Guys,
oh, ma'am.
All right, come on. So we have two operators, that is ampersand and then underscore, two underscore. So those two characters are called wildcard operator. Okay, wildcard operator are using with a like operator. So you see, when you are searching that names starting with A or, you know, in between anywhere, if you want to find out T, so what you do within double quotes, you know, like within double quotes, ampersand and then T, and then after that ampersand, it will search this column. Okay, for example, it will search this column. If anywhere in this name of, you know, or record as T, it will display. So, you know that in a playing cards, you know, wild card, how do you say that? You know, joker or something, right? So those kind of things you will insert or something, and then you will get you know, you will declare that your game, right? Same way, you know, wildcard characters are, you know, you can insert anything use without having clock the like using the like operator, and then you will get the result. So, you know, ampersand and then underscore, two underscore, those two operators are called wildcard character. Okay. Okay, let me write here. Okay, I found it. Let me take first table. Which table? Customer, and then these two tables we linked it before, right? So we saw that, right? We have foreign key, primary key, constant. Okay, let me write it. Select last. Oh, come on, it's not writing it here. Select last name. Name underscore. Why I am writing just a simply last name, because in both table, you know, attributes names are completely different, so you don't need to define here a dot or whatever. So later I will, you know, when I select the table, I will use it. Okay, so first name, and then first name, and then order. O-R-D-R. Hey, guys, check whether I'm doing spelling correct or not, okay? Order date, comma, order ID.
Okay.
Order ID. And then from, comma, I want one more thing.
Order ID.
Ah, okay, yes. Order ID. Order ID, amount from customer. Okay, customer space A, and then comma order or D or orders or order orders space B. Then I'm going to use some condition where you know A dot SID, yes underscore ID equal to B dot where is B dot customer or customers. Let me see. Customer only. Customer underscore yes underscore ID. Then and amount is greater than 2000. There is a problem. I don't know where it is. B dot customer dot something. Okay, let me run this query. We will.
And problem.
Huh? Unspelling. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Let me run this. See, we got it. Ram, Suji, and then we have only one. Okay. So we are picking that last name, first name, order date, order ID. We are just doing simple query. We are not doing any calculation or anything. From two tables. So we are, you know, we're linking with the primary foreign key constraint. Then we picked a table item name, column name, and then we want to only one condition. You know, whether this customer ID from customer table and then this column name is equal and amount is greater than 2000 means we want to, you know, fetch the records and then display. Okay. So in this way, you can do that. So I have created one more table here. Sample. Okay. Sample admission. No. Customers and company. Okay. Let me take the questions and then we will see that. company. Okay, to display those company name which are having less, you know, price 3000. So let me copy this.
30,000.
One second. 30,000. Yes. Okay, we will delete this from backslash start and then paste. Oh my God. It's in, right? Well, okay, let me write one by one. I don't want everything together. It makes messy.
That's fine, though.
Okay, how to write a query for that?
Start from?
Yeah, no. Few minutes, you keep silent. Saravanan, can you tell me that? So our question is to display those company name. Okay, let me take you know, the tables, then you will see it and then explain. Okay, we gonna use from a sample. Okay, let me run this. Okay, then I want to display that customer. Select star from customer. Okay. Saravanan, are you ready?
Ma'am?
Yeah, tell me. This is the question to display those company name which are having price less than 30,000. So can you see that record here on the bottom? Okay, now we want to write a query to display those company name. So what you have to write it?
Company name, ma'am.
Huh?
In this table, which is company name, ma'am?
Company. Oh, here. One second. This one. Because these two things are linked, right? I have to mention before. This customer table and then company table. Okay, let me take it this. You know, this is the customer ID is a primary key. And then when I take a company name, company, can you see that here? There is a no foreign key. Oh, I have linked it. I thought I have linked it. Otherwise, you cannot write it. Okay. So, we'll do one more thing before we are writing this question. So how to, you know, I have only created as with a primary key. I want to create a, you know, foreign key. So how do you do that? So, you know, see that record. This is the, you know, company table. So here we have company ID, name, city, and then product name. So let me close this one. So this is the customer table. So, you know, using, viewing these two tables, how do you define this is the, you know, parent table and this is the children table. So how do you see that? Anyone?
Which has customer ID.
Okay, first let me open that company table. So if you see that company table, we have some records, company ID and then name, city and then product name. So if you take that customer table, so we have customer ID and then name and then price, quantity and then CID. So by looking at these two tables, you can say that which one is a parent table, which one is a children table. So we can only match with you know, company ID, right?
Name also, no, ma'am.
Name?
Yes,
you know, company name Sony, Nokia, blah blah blah. But here name is Rohit Sharma. This customer name is, we have written only no, customer name.
Saying about the attribute, ma'am. Here also table column name is name.
Yeah, exactly. Yes. So this is why I have you know explained that a dot alias name you can assign. Okay. So if you want to display that, yeah, good catch. If you want to display that name of the product, so you know if you write only name, then you know definitely it will throw error because which name you want to display. So maybe it may throw Cartesian error, or we will see now. Okay, sometimes you know it will fetch only the parent table name. Okay, so but if you explicitly you want to display that child table name or whatever. So you have to specify alias name, A dot or B dot or something. Okay, we will try now. Now we haven't linked with a parent table. So how do you link with that? So by looking at this table, you can say that this is unique, right? So CID is a unique. So can you see my cursor movement here? No.
Yes, ma'am.
I am rotating my cursor. Can you see that?
Yes, ma'am. We can see, ma'am.
Okay. So because I'm pointing out a customer ID, so maybe you don't know. I wonder. That's why I asked. Okay. By looking at this table, two tables, you can you can easily say that a CID is a it is a parent table because the CID has unique value, so it is not repeated. So if you look at the customer table, so the customer ID is unique. So in this table, this is the customer ID is primary key, but we can link with customer ID, right? CID. So this is the customer table is a parent, a child table. So I want to create a link with that. So how do you write it? So that's good thing. I have done without creating a primary foreign key constraint. Okay, let's write it. How do you write it? Come on, guys. Alter. You are going to alter something in which table? So we are going to change customer table. So write a custom table name. Customer. Then, you have to write table, right? T-A-B-L-E, table, customer table. What you are going to do? You are going to add foreign key, right? F-O-R-I-R-I-E-G-N or other way around. This is correct, or R-E-I-G-N? Which one is spelled correct?
E-I-G-N.
F-O-R-I-E-G-N or, come on guys.
E-I-G-N, ma'am.
E-I.
Yes, ma'am. E-I-G-N.
Uh-huh. Foreign key. Foreign key is which one? SID, right?
Yes, ma'am.
CAD.
CAD.
Yeah, CAD. Then you cannot leave like that. So you have to reference that which one? So reference of, you have to write the keyword reference. R-E-F-E-R-A-N-C-E. Yes, references of parent table name. So what is a parent table? Company. Then within bracket at which column you are linking with CAD. That's it. Okay. So okay, if you run this query, let me run this. Okay, done. Everything is done. And now we can write this one to display those company name which are having price less than 30,000. See, this is what. One second, guys. Okay, this is customer table, children table, but we want only company name. So, which company sold, less than 30,000. So this is the question, right? So in company table, we have Sony, Nokia, Sony, from Delhi or Sony from Mumbai. You can do any condition. Sony from Mumbai, less than or greater than or equal to 30,000 or whatever. You can write a query like that. So, but first we will start from a small piece. Okay, simple example. So, to display those company name which are having price less than 30, write a query. Select.
Point out someone.
Point out someone, Prabhakaran. Come on, Prabha, tell me that. Select. Name, which name you want to display? So company name. So here, if you pick name means in both table, we have a same column name, right? Exact column name. So if you want to change it, you can, use alias. Company is a parent or child. Company is a parent, right? So A dot, you can change it B dot, but whenever you call that function, B dot company or A dot a customer, you have to give proper way. So, okay, let's make it select name from company, right? That is a question. So display the those company names. So select name.
Price also, no, ma'am. Select a dot name, comma.
Check the question. We want only company name. We don't want to display the price or whatever. So only we have to check price is less than 30,000.
Okay,
display the company name. That's it.
Okay.
I have to explain. If it is select this is the question. Ma'am. One second. I have something I have to show you. If you pick a company name on the price as well, they will reduce mark. Okay, let me show you first because how they allot marks. I can show you. See, can you see that? A half mark for correct select, half mark for correct wear class. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, when that's why I keep on telling you, read question properly. If you, if you select customer name and then comma price, definitely they will reduce your mark. Okay. Let's move on. Select the A dot name from company. Then where our query, what is the condition where? Come on. So you have to check, price. So how do you check it? Where? Okay, you can write company A. Right? You can write it, right? Where A dot?
Comma.
A dot?
Ma'am, comma customers B.
Comma customers B. You don't need it. No,
yes,
you
ma'am.
Don't.
Then
no, you don't need it. So you can, where? You can equal to you A dot company CID equal to B dot company CID. That is fine. Okay. You can write it or otherwise you can write this way. So in this,
how can we even display that?
Okay. Listen. Only one thing. So we are only selecting name from company. So you don't need to write A dot or B dot or something, because if you pick, name comma, another table from here, if you are picking quantity or whatever, that time only you have to write column name from company comma customer. So now what you are doing, you are picking name from company. That's it. Okay, so now we can link with that table. What is that? Customer 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 dot CID equal to company dot CID, right?
Yes,
company dot CID. And so we want to display prices less than 30,000, right? That's it. Okay, let me run this query. What happened? Any syntax error, maybe? One second. See, we have syntax error. Limit. It's saying company CID and then we have exact name or not. We are using sample. Okay, then. This one is fine, and then alter table. We haven't put any comma here. Now add foreign key. No, this is wrong. Select name from company where company dot CID equal to customers or customer.
Customers.
Yes. See, you got it. Now let's run this query. Again, it's showing error. We can write other way around. Company is a parent key, equal to this. Let's run this. What is wrong with that? From price less than 30, less than or equal to 30. No, less than 30 is fine. Select name from company where company.cad. Spell everything is correct. Equal to customers. customers.cad and price. Ma'am. What is that? Yeah. What alter we are doing? Table. Huh? Alter table alter custom.
Table.
Oh shit. Yes. Exactly, man. That is why we are getting trouble, huh? Okay, let me run this query. Running. Yes, now we can, you know, we have linked. Before, I know something wrong, we didn't notice it because I closed this tab, that is why. Ah, okay, let me run this. Again, it is showing me error, maybe linking trouble or I don't know. Let me run this, select me, what is the error? Where company.cad customer. Okay, let us pick something else, okay, come on. Customer name, okay. A dot customer, we will pick, it will work or not. A dot customer, comma, B dot customer, company. Guys, help me, sleeping?
No, ma'am.
Company, no, this one is name. Name from, B is the customer. CASDOERS customers B. Where? Okay, then we don't need to write this A dot CAD and then B dot CAD. Yeah, we got it. Guys?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see that? Okay, yes, somehow I'm, done mistake. Okay. See, what I did, I selected that, name from one table and then same attribute name from another table. So, from which table you are picking it? So, company. So, I give an alias name like that. Just one blank space and then from customer table, I am using B. Then where A.CAD equal to B.CAD and the price is less than or equal to 30 means I have written these two. Okay. So this is how you're going to write a developer queries. Okay. Try this one. So only you have to display that, only name. So we can do that. So where I am doing mistake right now, I don't want to spend more time. Okay. So maybe I can try this. Pick up this. Okay, let's write it. And then write. Yes, Jashwant, can you see that? So I picked A dot name from company A and then customer B and then I passed query that A dot CAD. That's it. Okay. So yes, let's make sure this is from company. Yeah, we have Sony, Nokia, this and that. Okay, let's check, Sony and Vonida. Let's check here. We have Sony twice and then Vonida. Let's go to customer table, greater than 30. Okay, compare with ID 111 and then 333 and then 444. Okay, here we have any order from 111. Yes. This is 30,000 and then 333. We have 35,000 and then 444. We have 44. Sony 444. What we got it? Vonida. Echoing man, Vonida is 333. Sony 444. We shouldn't get this one. Okay, we got only this. 111, 30,000 also, we have less than 30. Okay, then, right. So our query is just less than 30. So We got it. Okay. So we have, okay, I will explain clearly. We have Sony, Onida, and then again Sony. So just mark the number CID 111333444. It will pick three records. And then from customer table, less than 30,000. Okay, here CID, this is, not less than 30,000. Then it will pick this. It will pick this. Okay, so even though it return this value. Okay, I don't know. Less than or equal to means what happened. Guys, work on this query and then make sure, okay? So you know what, if I put less than 30,000, we get only one Sony. Then you know, if I put less than or equal to 30,000, we get this one. Okay, compare with the records tables. Oh, you don't have table, right? Okay, so mark this query and then whenever you get time, then run it. Okay, let's move on to next question. I don't want to sit. Already time's up. To display the name of the companies in a reverse alphabetical order. So this is easy, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, write it. Anyone? Hash symbol and then, okay. To display, Prabhakaran or, Ritin, anyone who is in line?
Unknown.
Hey, Kaushik.
Both
Anyone can tell me to display the name of the companies in reverse alphabetical order. How to write a query? Simply select then name from company.
Name from company.
Then order by
name
descending.
Semicolon.
Reverse alphabetical order. Okay, so which means it is a descending order. So Sony and then Samsung and then Onida. Okay, then yes, let's move on to the next question. To increase the price by 1,000 for those customer whose names start with S. One second. Okay, how to write it? To increase the price for those customers. So which means you are changing something, you are updating, altering means, the difference between update and alter, right? Altering means table wise you are altering. Update means you are particularly changing, with some condition. So update, yeah, write the query, update customer because update increase customers. Price by 1,000 for those customer who name starts update. With S. Yeah. Update customer.
Customers set.
One second. Customers set price
equal to price plus 1,000.
Price plus 1,000. Condition where name like.
Okay.
We can do that, right? So name like within bracket starts with yes, then ampersand symbol, that's it. Okay, we are using a wildcard character. So this is the wildcard character. Okay, let's semicolon. Customer table, I want to show that customer table. Okay, let me take a today. Okay, so now we can run this query. Okay, it is updated. Let me take that. Select star from customer. Simultaneously, are you testing it?
No, ma'am.
No? Okay, no. If you are testing it, that is cool. Can you see the difference or not?
Yes, ma'am.
Here. You see 2000 because name, customer name is S. This one here, Shagil Bansal. Before we have 3500, and then this one is 2000, and that's it, right? These two records are updated. Can you see that? 36,000, here 21,000. Before we have 35,000 and then 20,000. Okay. Next, move on to, okay, let me ask you something. If I run this query, what will happen? What is the output of it? If I run this or that? One second. I need to change something. Okay. Mobile. Maybe product name, city, customers. That's right, right? Maybe anywhere something wrong. Okay, 8. Okay. If I run this query, what I will get? Okay, let me show you that. What is the question? Product name is mobile. Okay. Then ACID, when it is equal, then I want to pick product name, city, and then price. So let's go back. Go back here. Do we have mobile here? Yes. 1.
Yes.
Two,
Sony,
3.
BlackBerry, Nokia.
Then Nokia, Sony, BlackBerry. So what is product name is mobile? Okay. So we will get a product name, city, price.
It will be from, yes, ma'am.
Okay. Let me run this. Only we get mobile and mobile Mumbai and then 25. Why it is that? Because condition. So let's see that. BlackBerry, what we got? Only Sony, right? Sorry, Mumbai 7000. Mumbai. This not displayed. Let me see, because company haven't, so you know, anyone, none of the customer purchased this one. Let's see that. So customer ID is 555. Okay, company. Okay, only one thing. Okay, only one thing. I don't want to skip this one. Okay, so here we got only these two, mobile from Mumbai and then mobile Mumbai whatever. So go to company table. We have three products: mobile. So check that CID. 222-444-555. Why we got only two means? So we pass that query that where A CID equal to B CID. If this condition is true means, this product name equal to mobile. This both condition is true means we are, you know, displaying this three. Okay. So we checked it 222 and then 444-555. Let's go to customer table. Do we have any 555 here? No, right? So that is why it picked only.
No, ma'am. Yes.
So it picked 222, this one. Price and then 444, right?
Yes, ma'am.
222 and 444. It displayed that value. So city and then price. It picked city from here and then price from here. Okay, guys, you find that, right? See, price is 25,000, 7,000. Okay, then just note it down. Maybe I can take a screen, write a table in a notepad here. I can send it to you. Okay, so you can, you know, anytime you can see that. If you don't have a computer or laptop to download MySQL, anytime I can, you know, those tables are not from your book. I have, you know, checked the internet and the many places, W3 school. I can write a table in a notepad. I can send it to you if you want. Okay. Bye, guys.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Have a nice day, ma'am.
You too. Bye.